the atomic bomb, Bitcoin, like, you know, interesting analogy. You know, sort of these sort of fundamental, you know, technology breakthroughs that like look like they're going to change the world in unpredictable ways. And for non-technical people, that can be weird and scary because who knows what the consequences are going to be, and who knows, you know, how to think about these things. Money is interesting in that context because money is something that I would argue has been on the non-technical side of the culture for the last 300 years for sure, with paper money and then before that, which is when sort of normal people think about money, they think about money in terms of who can you trust, right? So which institution can you trust? Can you trust the U.S. government and government officials? Can you trust the U.S. Treasury Department? Can you trust the U.S., you know, Mint to catch, you know, counterfeiters? It's very much, you know, can you trust the banks? Can you put your money in the bank? Are you going to be able to get the money back out? Do you trust the bank? Do you trust the government standing behind the bank? And so sort of our sort of cultural, broad cultural view of money is it's based on trust in people and institutions. On the engineering side of things, people and institutions are beside the point. The core of it is, can you trust the math, right? Can you trust the math? Can you trust the algorithms? Can you trust the code? And can you trust cryptography? And so part of what's happening right now is engineers look at this and they're like, oh, it's obvious that the Bitcoin is better because it's math that you can trust as opposed to people who you just never know, as we discovered in 2008. Normal people look at that and they're like, how can you trust math? Like, does that mean you have to be a mathematician, right? You have to have a PhD in mathematics in order to understand computer science to understand this stuff. And so I think what has to happen is actually the cultures have to come together. And for that to happen, basically, you know, two things are required, which is one is the engineering culture, which we represent, which a lot of us, you know, here today represent. We have to really work hard to be able to explain this stuff and articulate it and simplify it and make it easy to use and make it understandable. And we have to reach across and we have to bring people with us as opposed to just having this be something that's going to freak everybody out. But people on the other side of the culture, people in the literary, liberal arts, you know, sort of non-technical culture need to be open-minded and need to be willing to engage and understand and learn.